This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to continue our work with simple interest problems, and we're going to do this problem here, but we've got three different questions, depending on when he pays off the loan. All right, here's a simple interest problem. Juan borrows $6,000 from a bank at 8% interest. How much does he owe the bank at the end of 3 years to pay off the loan? All right, so this is simple interest, and our interest rate we see is 8%. He borrows $6,000 and he keeps that money for 3 years before he pays it off. So remember, the formula is interest equals principal times rate times time. So we don't know the interest. That's what we're looking for. So let's write down what the principal and the rate and the time are. Principal is the amount of money borrowed or lent or put in a bank, etc. And that would be $6,000. And it's really $6,000. I'm leaving off the dollar sign, but if you want, you could put it there. The rate, 8%. Now, remember, when you put in a percent in a formula, you need to change that to either 0.08 or 0.08. Now, of course, you can reduce that fraction, but in other words, you need to write it either as a decimal or as a fraction. And what's the amount of time we're talking about? 3 years. Remember, the time always has to be in years. So if it said 3 months, that would mean something very different. In fact, we'll do that next. So we've got 3 for 3 years. And we're not asked for the amount of interest. We're asked how much does he owe the bank at the end of 3 years. But we need to figure out the interest first so that we could add that to the $6,000. So we have interest equals 6,000 times our rate. Now, you can either put 0.08 or 0.08. I'm going to go ahead and do fractions. I don't like using calculators if I could do it in my head, but it's fine if you're allowed to use a calculator to go ahead and just put 0.08 and plug everything in the calculator. To me, it's easier to use my mind and practice my arithmetic skills. So that 100 is going to count, is going to get rid of those two right here. So basically, I'd have to multiply 60 times 8 times 3. Now, is there and you can multiply those numbers in any order. So how about I could do 6 times 8 times 3, or I could do 6 times 3 times 8, or I could do 3 times 8 times 6. I'm going to do 6 times 8 first. So that's 48, right? Notice I'm not dealing with that 0 yet, and then times the 3. So that would be 8 times 3 is 24, carry the 2, 12, 13, 14. But there's also that extra 0. So 6 times 8 times 3 is 144, and I've got the extra 0. So that's the actual amount of interest I have to pay at the end of 3 years. So what would be the total payoff? Well, we have our original amount, which was the $6,000 I'm going to have to add to that, right? So notice you got to add your interest to what you owe, that principal amount. So if I add that up, the payoff is $7,440. Lots of money. By the way, you know, if you wanted, you could figure out how much money you owe after 1 year and then just triple that. That's what this multiplying by 3 is, right? So if you just figure out the money after 1 year, you'd have 6,000 times 8%, which is, you know, I think $480. And then you would multiply it by 3. That's why you multiply by the amount of time, you know, if you're going to triple it, for instance, in this case. All right, let's do another problem. So as promised, let's do this similar problem, except he's going to pay it off in 3 months. So he's going to pay it off quickly. Instead of waiting for 3 years to pay it off, he's going to pay it off in 3 months. So we start off with the same formula, interest equals principal times rate times time. The principal is still $6,000. The rate is still 8%, but the time is different. And here's the trick. We've got 3 months, but you have to do it in years. So you have to change 3 months to years. What part of a year is that? And that would be 3/12 of a year. If I said 3 days, by the way, if you had 3 days, you'd have to think how many days are in a year. And of course, that's approximate, right? But you would have to do 3 out of 365. That's how you would do the time if it was in 3 days. So if it's in days, you're going to do it over 365. If it's in months, you're going to do it over 12 because there's 12 months. And if it's given in years, like in the first problem, that's easy. We just got t equals 3. So let's go ahead and figure this out. The principal is 6,000 again. The rate, okay, I'm going to write that again as 8/100. I do that a lot when we've got these extra zeros anyway. What the heck? And the time is 1/4 this time. Okay, so let's see. I can cancel out dividing by 100. That takes away 2 of those zeros. And what else can I cancel out here? 4 into 8 I could cancel. That's a 2. So notice I just have ones in the denominator. So I've got 60 times 2 times 1. That's only $120. So at the end of 3 months, he only owes $120 in interest. Be careful. So it's $120 in interest. But the question is, how much does he owe the bank? Okay, how much does he owe the bank? So he owes the $6,000 plus the 120 in interest, right? So you could say the payoff, no different ways to write your answer, is $6,120. All right, let's go ahead and figure out what he would owe if he paid it off in 3 days. In other words, right away he paid it off. So again, we start with the principal is 6,000. The rate is 8%. Now this time, I'm actually going to write this as a decimal. And the reason is I think I'm going to use a calculator on this one. What's the time? 3 days. That would be 3 over 365. Now, if you want, you could write this as a fraction. Like I said, you could even reduce it. Since I have one fraction in here, I'm going to do that. So, what would my interest be? Well, I would multiply these together. And now, this, yeah, you could do long division, multiplication, etc., but I think I'm going to use a calculator. So, we're going to have 6,000, right, times 3 over 365 times, you know what, I think I'm going to just keep this as 8/100 for this reason. I changed my mind. I'm going to just cancel the 2 just so I have less things to put in my calculator. All right, so in your calculator for the numerator, you're going to have, and actually, it's just not the numerator. In your calculator, you're going to enter 60 times 3 times 8, and then you're going to divide by 365. Right? So put that in your calculator. 60 times 3 times 8 divided by 365. Now, in your calculator, you're going to get a lot of numbers, but we need to round it. So, like for instance, in my calculator, mine comes up 3.9452, etc. We're talking about money here, so you're going to round right here, and you're going to round up. So the interest, really, you can't pay it, part of a penny, right? So your interest is going to be, if you round up, $3.95. So isn't that amazing? You can borrow $6,000 for 3 days, and that's how much you pay in interest, is $3.95. So then the question is, how much do you owe the bank at the end of 3 days? We'd have to add $3.95 to that $6,000. So you would have $6,003.95 is how much he owes the bank. Okay, now I always like doing this stuff with fractions, but just let me show you don't have to do that. You could say, well, like I was going to do originally, $6,000. You could put in the 0.08 and then you do 3 over 365. Okay, this works just as well. If you put in your calculator, 6,000 times 0.08 times 3 divided by 365, again, you're going to get the same thing. Remember, this goes on and on. So the interest is still going to be 395. I like just kind of playing around with fractions myself. Okay, so we'll do some more problems if you go on to my next video. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.